Guys, today I'm going to tell you a story about Don't Look Down at the Unfortunate. The bell for school dismissal had just rung. The students started to come out of their classes. Mei Ling took a crutch and placed it under her arm. Then she took her school bag. Mei Ling then informed her teacher, Che Amina, "I am going home now, teacher." Mei Ling walked towards the school gate. Adiba was already there waiting for Mei Ling. Suddenly, Mei Ling and Adiba saw Raza and his friends coming towards them. "Hey, Miss Lim, are you going back?" Raza began to tease Mei Ling. Mei Ling did not answer. Then Raza teased her again. "Why don't you say something? Don't you have a mouth?" Muttu then started teasing by saying, "Look, friends, look at her. She is only limping, but she is also a mute." Adiba could only look at Mei Ling, who was being teased by Raza and his friends. She felt sorry for Mei Ling. Suddenly, Adiba shouted, "Raza, why are you teasing Mei Ling?" Raza replied, "I am not teasing her, I am just asking." Then, Raza and his friends, Muttu, Laman and Raja, began to laugh teasingly at Mei Ling and Adiba. Adiba warned, "Just wait and see. I will report this to Che Amina." Then Raza and his friends walked away, still singing. Mei Ling said, "Thank you, Adiba. They always disturb me. I don't know what to do." Adiba replied, "It's all right, Mei Ling. I hope you won't feel too sad," Mei Ling said. "No, I won't. I don't lose anything anyway." One evening, Mei Ling wanted to go to the library. Then she came across Raza and his friends again. Raza shouted at Mei Ling, "Hi, Miss Lin, where are you going to with your crutch?" Mei Ling did not bother about Raza and just walked on. Raza and his friends followed Mei Ling. They teased at the way how Mei Ling walked. Muttu walked in a limping manner while holding his knees. Laman walked as if he was in pain. Raza laughed and then came near to Mei Ling. Mei Ling still took no notice of Raza and his friends. Suddenly, Raza grabbed Mei Ling's crutch away from her. Mei Ling pleaded, "Raza, please don't return me. Please don't disturb me. Sorry, guys. Please don't disturb me. Please return my crutch. I am going to the library." Raza replied while laughing, "I am just borrowing it for a while." Mei Ling could not continue walking without the crutch. Raza held the crutch under his arm and began to walk like Mei Ling did. Mei Ling pleaded again, "Please, Raza, please return my crutch. I have not done anything wrong to you." Raza said, "You are a proud village girl. You did not answer the first time I spoke to you." Raza carried on imitating the way Mei Ling limped. Mei Ling felt hurt at the way she was being teased. Then Mei Ling tried to grab back her crutch from Raza. Raza ran to the middle of the road. Mei Ling continued chasing Raza. Suddenly, a car was seen speeding towards Raza. He could not avoid the car and was knocked down. Raza was thrown off to the side of the road. Mei Ling was shocked to see Raza being hit by the car. The car which hit Raza stopped at the side of the road. Then the driver quickly came out to help Raza, who was lying unconsciously on the road. Mei Ling pleaded, "Please, sir, send my friend to the hospital," the driver said. "Your friend is injured. He is bleeding badly. Let's bring him to the hospital quickly." The driver of the car carried Raza to his car. Mei Ling also followed them into the car to the hospital. Upon reaching the hospital, Raza was given immediate treatment. He had already lost a lot of blood due to the injury. A nurse who came out from the emergency room met Mei Ling and said, "Your friend requires a lot of blood. Unfortunately, our blood bank has run short of type O blood." Mei Ling said, "Please check my blood type. I am ready to donate if my blood is of the same." The nurse then checked Mei Ling's blood. Luckily, Mei Ling's blood is of the same type of Raza's. She then donated some of her blood to Raza. After that, Mei Ling returned home. Hopefully, Raza's health will improve. So, although Mei Ling Although Raza always teased her, Mei Ling felt sad because Raza was involved in the accident. A week later, Raza was discharged from the hospital. However, he could not walk normally as his legs were fractured. He was unable to attend to school for a month plus. Raza regretted making fun of Mei Ling. He was sad too because his friends did not come to visit him. One day, Raza's mother told Raza that Mei Ling was the one who accompanied him to the hospital. She also said that Mei Ling had donated blood to help save Raza. Then, Raza began to realize how kind Mei Ling was. He also regretted in teasing Mei Ling all this while. Raza's mother then told Raza to apologize to Mei Ling. Raza was too shy to face Mei Ling. After much persuasion from his mother, Raza finally agreed to meet Mei Ling. Then Raza went to Mei Ling's house. He was limping and using a crutch. Raza was sad when his friends walked away upon seeing him. When he reached Mei Ling's house, she was reading a book. She was surprised to see Raza. She invited Raza into the house. Then Raza went in shyly. "Actually, I came here to apologize to you. I have done many bad things towards you. I am very sorry, Mei Ling," said Raza.
"I accept your apology, Raza," replied Mei Ling.
"I want to thank you for saving my life," added Raza. Mei Ling answered, "I do not want anything from you, Raza. I am just happy that you are getting better and will go to school again soon." Raza smiled happily. He then promised that he would not tease or make fun of anyone again. That's all from me now. See you in my next video. Bye guys.